Hi there. We're glad you've joined us today. Let's jump up and sing.
God knows my thoughts, what I'm thinking. He knows everything, how I'm feeling. God knows me and you. Guess who? God knows my choices and my fears, 'cause he's always been here. God knows me and you. Guess who? Guess who? Guess who? God knows me. God knows you. God loves us so much, and he cares about us too. Guess who? Guess who? God knows my thoughts, what I'm thinking. He knows everything, how I'm feeling. God knows me and you. Guess who? My choices and my fears, 'cause he's always been here. God knows me and you. Guess who? Guess who? Guess who? God knows me. God knows you. God loves us so much, and he cares about us too.
Is a special hooray day, and we'll be learning that God values us. In the book of Matthew in the Bible, Jesus showed that he valued children by inviting them to come to him when others were trying to keep them away. Let's watch and see what happens.
Welcome to the clubhouse. My name is Aria.
I'm Mia.
I'm Liam. And we are
the Super Crew.
And this is our amazing wonder dog named Bark. Say hi, Bark.
I'm showing everyone my new invention. It's called the Feely Wheelie. With this invention, I can see right here what people are feeling or what's going on inside. Let's see. Aria, you first. How do you think Aria is feeling?
Happy!
Yes, 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 you are right. Nice job. Oh, what about Bark?
How do you think Bark is feeling?
Silly!
Nice job. Mia, it's your turn. Okay, how do you think Mia feels?
Mad!
Oh, Mia, it looks like you're mad. Are you okay?
Well, I spent all day yesterday painting a picture for my mom, but before I could give it to her, I knocked over my paint and spilled it all over my picture. Now my picture is ruined. I feel so mad about it.
I'm sorry, Mia, but you are so good at art. I know. Maybe we can help you make something new.
Yeah, I know if we work together, we can make something great for your mom.
Okay, thank you. It's great to share about my feelings. Did you hear that? It sounded like the super box. That's something that always makes me feel better. Let's go!
Did you send us something super?
Yes!
Great! Here at the clubhouse, we help connect the super clue, the big deal, and the Bible. Today's big deal is, guess who? God knows me and you.
Let's look together and see what's inside.
Oh, look, it's a stethoscope. I've seen this before at the doctor's office when I get a checkup. It's a way for a doctor to hear things that are inside your body, like your heart. But I wonder, how does a stethoscope connect to our big deal? Guess who? God knows me and you. Can you wonder with us?
Perfect. I think I got it. A stethoscope is used by a doctor to know what is going on inside our bodies. God always knows how we are feeling, even if we don't understand. He knows when we feel happy, sad, or even mad.
That's right, Mia. Our big deal today is, guess who? God knows me and you. God knows our feelings, the things we feel on the inside. Because he knows exactly how we feel, he knows exactly what we need, so we can ask God for help.
Now, be looking, because you're going to see the super clue again. When you see the super clue, here's what I want you to do. Since our super clue is a stethoscope, I want you to pretend you are listening inside of your body. Can you try it with me? See the super clue, listen inside of you. Great job.
I know where we can learn about how God knows us. Let's
look in the Bible.
Remember, the Bible is God's book.
The Bible is true, and it's for you.
Today's Bible story comes from the book of Luke. Can you say Luke?
Luke!
Perfect, perfect, perfect. In this Bible story, we will see two women who Jesus, God's son, visited. Let's see what the Bible says.
Mary and Martha. Jesus and his friends were traveling when they came to a place where a woman named Martha lived. Martha invited Jesus and his friends to her house. While Jesus was at her house, Martha's sister, Mary, sat at Jesus' feet and listened to him talk. Instead of listening to Jesus, Martha was busy doing chores to make Jesus and his friends feel welcome. Martha said to Jesus, "My sister is not helping me do the chores. Don't you care that I am doing all of the work by myself? Tell her to come and help me." Jesus knew what Martha was feeling. Jesus said, "Martha, you are worried and upset about many things, but Mary is making the right choice. She is listening to me, and that is the most important thing."
Jesus really showed Martha that he cared for her, even when she was upset. Jesus knew how she felt and cared about Martha and her feelings. He wanted her to see what the most important thing was. The most important thing was that Jesus was there and she could spend time with him. Jesus knew how Martha was feeling, and he helped Martha focus on the most important thing.
Do you see something? It's our super clue! Do you remember what to do? Great job. God knows us. He knows how we feel and wants to help us. So, next time you see a stethoscope, you can remember that God knows your feelings and he cares how you feel. So,
we have learned that God knows us. God loves us, knows how we are feeling, and can help us pay attention to him and make the right choice.
That is a big deal. Let's say our big deal together. I'll say it first, and then you say it after me. Guess who?
Guess who?
God knows me and you.
God knows me and you.
Great job.
God knows us and wants to help us, no matter what we are feeling inside. Whenever you start having feelings you don't understand, you can stop, take a deep breath, and ask God for help. He knows how we feel and wants to help us with our feelings. Hey, Liam, let's try out the Feely Wheelie again. I'm feeling a lot better.
Great idea. Thanks, everyone, for joining us at the clubhouse today. We'll see you next time. Say bye, Bark.
Bye. Bye.
Hey, friends. Let's learn a verse from the Bible that tells us that God knows everything about us. Remember, the Bible is God's book. The Bible is true, and it's for you. Now listen and watch it first as we learn it together. God is greater than our hearts, and He knows all things. 1 John 3:20b. I want everyone to stand up so we can say the Bible verse. I'll say it first, then you can repeat it after me. God is greater.
God is greater.
Than our hearts.
Than our hearts.
And He knows all things.
And He knows all things.
1 John 3:20b.
1 John 3:20b.
This verse tells us that God is better than anything. He also knows everything too. We know we can trust God in good times and in bad times because He knows everything. Let's say the verse again as you repeat it after me. God is greater.
God is greater.
Than our hearts.
Than our hearts.
And He knows all things.
And He knows all things.
1 John 3:20b.
1 John 3:20b.
Great job! God knows everything about us. Because He knows everything, we can trust what He says. Let's say it one more time, all together. But this time, with our outside voices! Ready? One, two, three.
God is greater than our hearts, and He knows all things. 1 John 3:20b.
God knows us, and we can trust Him no matter what. See you next time.
It doesn't matter whether you're a grown-up or young like you. God knows you, He values you, and He loves you so much. He thinks you are so important that He sent Jesus to die for you. Let's pray. God, thank you for sending Jesus to die for us, that we might have the assurance of someday being in heaven with you. We pray that you will live in our hearts, that you would guide us and help us in good times and in rough times. We love you and thank you for loving us. And everybody said, amen. We'll see you next time. Bye.